Okazaki. What's up? Is something wrong?
You weren't around, so I went looking for you. Don't tell me you've been practicing for the play in a place like this every night.
Well, not every night. I can't really practice at home, because if I sing or raise my voice, it'll bother the neighbors.
All right, but try to be careful. It's dangerous to be in a place like this alone.
It's right by my house. Even if something did happen, all I have to do is scream and Dad will come running.
Yeah, but you're kind of dense, so I worry sometimes.
Huh? I don't really seem that dense, do I?
I thought it was obvious.
I'm really shocked.
You get depressed way too easy. It's not so bad.
It was a joke. I've gotten used to it already. All your teasing, I mean.
When you put it that way, it makes me feel kind of guilty. Anyway, sorry. I guess I should watch what I say.
It's fine. Actually, please don't change. I like you just the way you are.
Sure. No problem. Did you decide on what play you want to do?
It's the same one I wanted to do before. I don't know the title, but it's a story I heard when I was young.
So what's it about?
It's a story about a girl who lives all alone, because she's the last person alive.
Huh?
Nothing dies, and nothing is born in the world. It's a tragic fantasy on a cold winter's day.
Living in a world that has ended. Somehow I feel like I've heard of that before. No, I'm sure of it. Just can't remember when or where.
I'm useless! Nothing but a burden to the bakery!
But I love your bread! Screwed that up.
Oh, what is it this time?
I was recommending Sinai's bread to one of our customers and she said it was inedible. Sinai overheard it and got upset. We call this one a rainbow roll. Feel the rainbow!
I'm not really sure what that means.
A girl living in a world that has ended? Nope, sorry, but I'm afraid that doesn't ring a bell.
Could you try a little harder to jog your memory? Like, did you ever read Nagisa a fairy tale like that when she was little?
Nope, don't remember. Why don't you ask Sinai?
I see. All right, then.
Hey, kid.
Huh?
I don't know what you're up to, but to tell you the truth, I don't like the sound of it. So listen, if you find out something strange, don't tell Nagisa. Run it by me first.
Why should I?
Just do it. Got it?
No, I don't remember anything like that at all.
Come on, can you try to think back a little bit? It might not be a storybook, it may have been something on TV.
It might help if you told me how the story ends.
Nagisa said it was a tragic fantasy, so I'm thinking it might not have a happy ending.
A tragic fantasy, huh? I can't think of anything. Besides, tragedies aren't really my specialty, so I can't imagine I told any to Nagisa. It might be something she heard at school or somewhere else.
Oh, I see.
I'm sorry. Is it something important?
Well, kind of. I guess. Something important. I don't know why, but somehow I get the feeling it is.
Well, just because I don't remember it doesn't mean she never read it. Maybe it's still lying around the house somewhere, tucked away in a corner. You could also look at the school library.
Thanks, that's a good idea. I'll try it.
Sorry, but I don't think we have a book like that here. We don't have many children's books or picture books.
It's a high school library, so I guess that's no surprise.
We have quite a collection of plays and drama videos for high schoolers, though. Do you think that might help?
I appreciate it, but I don't think it was originally a play or a performance piece.
I see.
Hey, Yukine, help me out! I'm looking for a spell that can tell me which girl has a crush on me. Do you think you can show me?
Jeez, we were talking about something serious here.
I've got just the spell.
Whoa, for real?
Ta-da! First, you form a little heart shape with your thumbs and index fingers, just like this. After that, repeat, she loves me not, 3 times in a row.
She loves me not. She loves me not. She loves me not. Okay, now what?
For the last part of the spell to work, all you need to do is take a quick walk around the campus. The first girl who talks to you after that is the one who likes you.
Oh! Awesome! Here I go!
Hey.
Yes?
If there's a guy and he likes a girl, do you think she would like him to tell her?
Oh, you mean like you and Furukawa?
I never said that.
Naturally, if the feeling is mutual, then the girl would be happy to hear it. However, keep in mind that timing is an important factor as well. If you're too sudden or too forceful, it can cause her feelings to change.
So that's how it is, huh?
How did it go?
Leave me alone.
How many times did you run around? And even after all that, not a single girl said a word to you?
Hold on, let me get you some water. All right, Okazaki, now it's your turn.
I'm supposed to do it too?
Form a heart with your fingers, just like this.
All right, but let's make this fast. Come on, Sonohara, move. It's nothing personal, but somehow I feel like you're the last person I should get romantically involved with. Listen, there's a big bear that eats little girls prowling around the school right now. If you want to make it out alive, then act like you're dead and don't say a word. Just pretend you're a zombie, okay?
Okazaki?
What?
You were late, so I came looking for you. Why are you standing here in the hall?
She loves me. She loves me now.
Now just go outside and start walking around the campus. The first girl who stops and talks to you has a crush on you.
What's wrong, Okazaki?
It's nothing.
Looks like everyone's here now. I heard this story a long time ago. But I don't remember the name, and I don't remember if it was a picture book or something someone told me or what. But anyway, the story is about a little girl who is all alone in the world. It's very lonely for her. Very sad and very difficult. Mm-hmm. There's nothing and no one else in the world. But one day, the little girl decides to create a friend. Oh. So she puts together a bunch of odds and ends and makes a mechanical doll. And then, as if answering the girl's wishes, the doll begins to come alive. At long last, the girl's loneliness goes away.
Now I'm sure I've heard it before.
Come look! You won't believe what I just found!
What is it?
Isn't it cute? Back when I was in elementary school, I used to have this charm on my school bag. Dango, dango, dango.
Are you a little old for that sort of thing?
Hey! Who's singing that embarrassing song in my shed?
Your daughter, that's who.
We're looking for something. I thought I might be able to find some old picture books or fairy tales I read when I was little.
Trust me, there aren't any picture books in there.
Who knows what'll turn up if we look hard enough?
It's not there, okay? So just get back to making out in the bedroom or whatever you kids do these days. What am I saying? I can't encourage that!
Calm down, you're the one who said it, not me.
Just get out of there already! Come on, move it!
What do you want with me?
Just listen. What I'm about to tell you is for your ears, not Nagisa's. And since this is a man-to-man conversation, I don't want you telling Sanai about this either. It would only stir up old memories.
That's fine.
Some tea would be nice.
Hey, Sanai, bring us some tea, will you please?
Okay.
Damn, I forgot we were supposed to keep us a secret from Sanai!
I think you need to take your brain in for some repairs.
Man, that was close. Anyway, we're safe now. To tell you the truth, kid...
Here's your tea.
Oh, thanks a lot.
You have some too, Okazaki.
Thanks.
Yep, if you're Japanese, it's gotta be tea. Now I'll say it one more time. Keep this a secret from Sanai and Nagisa.
What secret are you keeping from me?
You're standing right there!
After you finish your tea, I'll go back inside and you can have your secret man talk.
You heard her, kid! Now hurry up and drink!
Are you doing this on purpose or are you just stupid?
Alright, now we can finally talk in peace.
You're the one who was making it difficult in the first place.
Did you ever find what you were looking for?
No, not yet.
I see. Well, don't get me wrong, it's not like I cared in the first place. I'm not interested in digging up the old potty Nagisa used for toilet training.
You say it like I am.
Oh yeah? Seemed like you were looking pretty hard to me.
Yeah, for a picture book, not a training potty.
Hey, you two. It's late, so keep your voices down. You don't want to trouble the neighbors.
Well, whatever. Let's just forget about the potty.
You're the one who brought that crap up in the first place.
Oh yeah? Well, from now on, our code name is Training Potty. How you like that?
Fine. Whatever you want.
Good. Then let's move on. Whatever you're looking for isn't really the issue here. I was just a little worried that you might find something else while you were digging around out there.
Something else?
Do you want to know?
Well, not if you don't want to tell me.
It's fine, I'll tell you. If you don't know the truth, you'll probably just think I have an assload of porn magazines hidden out there.
Now you're just putting ideas in my head.
Listen, those things we got piled up back there in the shed, all of it, they're all pieces of our past.
Huh.
Old photos and diaries, that kind of stuff. Things to remind us of the days when we were young and chasing our dreams.
But why is it a problem if we see that?
Let me explain. We don't talk about this much, but when Nagisa was little, she almost died. She was face to face with death. It was a close call. It all happened about 10 years ago. Sanai was a middle school teacher, and I was finally able to follow my dream too. We had a busy life, but a happy one.
Your dream? What was that?
That's got nothing to do with this story. The only thing you need to know is that we were both focused on our careers. Too focused, actually. The truth is, we hardly ever found time to spend with Nagisa. Anyway, it all started when Nagisa came down with a fever. It was a cold, snowy day. Unfortunately, the daycare center was closed at the time, and we couldn't find anyone to babysit either. Even though our daughter was sick, it was a busy time for both of us, and regardless of the circumstances, we couldn't take off work. By that point, her temperature had come down and I figured I could go home as soon as I finished my work for the day. It was just 2 hours. Just 2 short hours. But... Nagisa had gone outside to wait for us to come home. I thought that God must be punishing us for being so selfish. He was taking Nagisa away because we were too busy chasing our dreams to worry about our own child. I'm sure there are plenty of people in this world who can balance their careers and their child. But we couldn't. We had to make a choice. When Nagisa opened her eyes again, the two of us made a pledge. We promised that we'd always be by her side. So we both changed careers and decided to start a bakery together, since Sanae was so confident about baking bread and all. Of course, you can imagine how that turned out, so if I wanted to survive, I had to learn the trade myself. It wasn't easy. We were always in and out of debt. But I can't say it wasn't fun.
But you don't want Nagisa to find out? Why not?
Because knowing her, she'll think it was her fault. She'll think she's the reason why Sanae and I had to give up on our dreams.
Actually, I'm not sure. But somehow I have this really bad feeling. Like something happened when I was little. It might not be my fault, but I feel like I must have done something really bad to him.
Eventually, Nagisa started to suspect that something was wrong, so we put all of our mementos into storage. Digging up all this crap is hard enough on me. Just imagine how sad it would make Sanae.
I don't know, but I still think you should tell Nagisa. It might be tough at first, but she deserves to know, and I'm sure she has the strength to deal with it.
Maybe so, but if we just break it to her out of the blue, then it'll come back as a pretty big shock. But someday, when the time is right, I'll tell her everything. But that's the truth for you. It's always harsh, isn't it?
Attention, please! It's time for a quiz! I've been planning something very special for Sunday, which is tomorrow, by the way. So, what do you think it is? Number one, a picnic. Number two, pick. Three, picric acid.
Hold on, I don't understand the last one.
Picric acid is a chemical compound. It's yellow, highly aromatic, and explosive.
I see. That's neat. Guess you learn something new every day.
All right, Nagisa, what's your answer?
Right. I choose picnic, number one.
Wrong! The correct answer is number two, pick. So tomorrow, we'll have fun picking all day.
Nagisa, you and I can still go on a picnic if you'd like, okay?
Huh?
Okay.
Wait, that's not fair! Don't leave me out!
Hey, is it okay if we forget about the drama club just for tomorrow and have a little fun instead?
Yeah, sounds good to me. We could use a break every once in a while.
Yeah.
By the way, Okazaki, would you mind telling me what kind of food you'd like to eat? I want to pack something that you'll enjoy as well.
Sure.
I want to eat apple slices cut up to look like rabbit ears!
No fair, Dad. Who said you got to go first? By the way, I'd like to request hamburgers, please.
Then I want some deep-fried shrimp.
I wonder if this is what a normal family is like. Somehow, I don't think I should go with them tomorrow. I wonder what Dad's doing right now.
Who's in my bed?
Who do you think? It's me.
Okazaki? What are you doing here?
Nothing, really. But what are you doing up so early?
Actually, I'm about to go to sleep. A picnic, huh? I have to admit, that's not really your style, is it?
Not at all. I figure if I went, it would just put a damper on their family get-together.
But isn't Nagisa expecting you? She'll be disappointed, won't she?
I left a note, so I'm sure she'll be fine. I have an errand to run, so please go without me, it says.
Yeah, but this is Nagisa we're talking about here. I'm sure she's gonna imagine the worst-case scenario. At least she'll think you feel uncomfortable staying at her house, don't you think?
Come on, she's not that sensitive. It's just a stupid little picnic, after all.
You ought to know that Nagisa has no confidence when it comes to these things. She's always worried. At least that's what it seems like to me.
Maybe before, but she told me she's been more confident lately.
That's just because you've been around. You're always scolding her and egging her on. That's why she's able to take on different challenges. That's why she feels more confident now.
Yeah, but that's a good thing, right?
Of course it is. That's what I'm saying. Think about this for a second. She's gained confidence because you've been around to help. Now, if you suddenly turn your back on her, what do you think will happen to all that confidence she's built up? Nagisa doesn't realize how you feel about her, so it's easy for her to get the wrong idea. You don't even think about it, but if you keep acting so wishy-washy, you're really gonna hurt her. First you run away from your dad's house, then you run away from Nagisa's house, too. Now you come running here and expect me to put you up? Fine. If you really don't want to go to the picnic, then I'd be more than happy to tag along in your place. And hey, if I'm lucky, love will blossom between Nagisa and I.
I'm leaving. Sorry I bothered you.
That's it for me.
Nagisa!
Okazaki, I was looking for you.
I left you a note. Did you get it?
Huh? No, I didn't see any note.
Where have you been all this time? We were starting to get worried.
You got my note, right?
Yeah, but I cooked it up and ate it for breakfast, so I never read what it said.
Why did you...
I wanted to play baseball, but it's getting kind of late now.
I'm sorry. Is it just...
You're gonna have to make up for keeping us waiting all day. And you can start by coming with us.
Huh?
Yay!
Am I on a roll today or what? You see that, Sinai?
I wouldn't miss it for the world.
You fall in love with me again?
Yep. Again and again, you're the best.
Of course I am!
She didn't have to spread it out on her picnic cloth and everything.
Okazaki, I helped Mom make all the food, so I hope it's good. Give it a try, okay?
Sure. Tastes great.
I'm so glad.
Hey, kid! Huh? Hurry it up! You're next to bat! Get your ass up to the plate already!
All right, I'm coming. Well, here I go.
Okay, now get out of here.
Come on!
I wonder if I can still hit with my shoulder. See that, Nagisa?
Yep. Wouldn't miss it for the world.
Did you fall in love with him again?
Yeah. Oh, Dad, come on.
Well, damn it! She does like him! Get over here, Nagisa. You're up to bat. Stop making me wait.
What, you mean I have to play too?
Go for it, Nagisa. Nice hit, Nagisa! Run for it, Nagisa!
It's a very oppressive sadness, don't you think?
Yes, it's very lonely and sad.